My name is Matt Zefferman. I'm a postdoctoral fellow here at NIMBioS. My research is into the origins of political institutions. In early human history, humans were organized in small-scale societies, which were very egalitarian and not very hierarchical. They were uncentralized. People would monitor and punish others, and these societies were generally small because monitoring and punishing others takes a lot of cognitive capacity, and there's only so many people you can monitor and punish at once. In my mathematical models, I'm interested in how we transition from these small-scale societies to larger political institutions. Most of us today live in societies that are very hierarchical, meaning they're structured, they have a very top-down structure, and also they're very centralized. We have centralized police forces in jails and centralized judicial systems and things that take care of a lot of the monitoring and punishing. In between small-scale early societies and large-scale societies, at some point there is a transition. And I'm interested in what are the kind of the prerequisites for that transition. What kind of things does society have to achieve to transition from these small-scale societies to large-scale societies? So in my models, I start off with a population of simulated humans that go about their business and they cooperate or not, and those that don't cooperate are monitored by others and are punished. And what I do in the modeling is I vary the efficiencies of monitoring and punishment. So mainly what I've learned here in my modeling so far at NIMBioS is really there's only two changes that are necessary to go from small-scale, decentralized societies to hierarchical organizations where punishment is centralized. One of them is monitoring efficiency, which is how many individuals another individual can monitor, and the other one is punishment efficiency, which is how many individuals does it take to punish someone for transgressing. And just by changing those two parameters and increasing the efficiency, and then having societies compete with each other, you can get to the point where you have very hierarchical, very centralized societies that can grow kind of to very large scales versus these kind of decentralized societies that can only exist really at small scales.
For more information about postdoctoral fellowships at the National Institute for Mathematical and Biological Synthesis, visit our website at www.nimbus.org.